Hello everyone, welcome to In 5 Minutes. In this video clip, we will discuss the very first problem on Thevenin's theorem. We have had introduction on Thevenin's theorem and Norton's theorem. So we will now apply Thevenin's theorem in finding current through a given resistance in one given circuit diagram. According to Thevenin's theorem, across any two terminals, entire network can be replaced with one single voltage source in series with one single resistance. So if I can do that, if I can reduce down the entire network to a single voltage source and single resistance, then analyzing that simplified network of one voltage source and one resistance will be very, very simple compared to dealing with the original circuit and applying different methods of analysis. So Thevenin's theorem is basically to simplify the whole analysis of circuit, which we do to find various currents and voltages. So let's now see how do we apply Thevenin's theorem to this very first problem. There are a few steps involved which you have to follow properly. The steps will be exactly same in every question. The only thing that is going to change in the circuit diagram. So accordingly, the intermediate analysis steps will change, but the overall steps that we have in the approach of using Thevenin's theorem will be exactly same. So let's see how to go about this particular question. Here, this is the 8 ohm through which I have to find out the current. We will define current through this 8 ohm resistance at the end. Right now, we will plan to replace the entire network except this 8 ohm resistance in its Thevenin's equivalent form. Once I have done that, I will come back and find out the resistance to this 8 ohm. I will find out the current through this 8 ohm resistance. So before we proceed, if we just want to get an idea of how the final circuit will look like, so this 8 ohm resistance, right now we will remove it from the circuit and we will treat only the remaining circuit to find its Thevenin's equivalent. But once we know the Thevenin's equivalent, we will draw the remaining circuit with the help of one voltage source and one resistance, which will have the values of VTH, RTH. And across these two terminals, we will be having 8 ohm resistance. So this will be my 8 ohm resistance. And you can see that finding current through this 8 ohm resistance will be much easier. All we'll have to do is apply a simple Ohm's law. But before I can do that, I'll have to get the values of VTH and RTH. That means looking through this 8 ohm resistance, we'll have to replace the entire network that we have using its Thevenin's equivalent. So for that to be possible, as I told you, we'll have to follow a few steps. Let's start with step number one. In step one, we will always find VTH, which is called Thevenin's equivalent voltage. So step one is about finding out what is the value of VTH. Now to find VTH, what exactly we have to do? We have to define open circuit terminals and define VTH across them. So we'll have to first define the open circuit terminals. These are the open circuit terminals across which we are finding out the Thevenin's equivalent. And later on, we will define the VTH, Thevenin's voltage, across those open circuit terminals. So where we should look for the open circuit terminals, either they will be directly given in the circuit, or it is always the ends of the resistor through which we have to either find current or voltage. So right now, because we have to find out the current through this 8 ohm resistance, what I'm simply going to do is I'm going to remove this 8 ohm from the circuit, and that gives me two open circuit terminals. So define open circuit terminals. That first part is done. These are the two open circuit terminals that we had to define. And now define VTH across them. So I'll call this open circuit terminals as A and B. I'll just give them some name, and I will now define voltage VTH across these two terminals with positive polarity at point A and negative polarity at point B. VTH sometimes is also called VOC, where OC stands for open circuit. It is called open circuit voltage because it is found between two open circuited terminals. So we have to now use any method of analysis that we want and find out VTH in this particular circuit. So to find out VTH, let us decide to use nodal analysis. So we can use nodal analysis. One can also go for mesh analysis. In this circuit, you can see that there are only two nodes. This is first node and this is the second bottom node, which can be taken as the ground node. So if I simply apply KCL at this particular node, I will have only one equation. I can find out the node voltage, and then somehow we can obtain the value of VTH.